আজকে আপনারা স্লোগান দিয়ে অভিবাদন দেন শেখ মুজিবের পথ ধরো
বাংলাদেশ স্বাধীন করো
বাজের ভাইয়ের পথ ধরো
বাংলাদেশ স্বাধীন করো
বাজের মাঠে তৈরি করো
বাংলাদেশ স্বাধীন করো
বীর বাগানে অস্ত্র ধরো
বাংলাদেশ স্বাধীন করো
বীর
আপনারা জোরে স্লোগান ধরেন আমার দেশ তোমার দেশ
বাংলাদেশ বাংলাদেশ
আমার দেশ তোমার দেশ
বাংলাদেশ বাংলাদেশ
স্বাধীন করো স্বাধীন করো
বাংলাদেশ স্বাধীন করো
My dear brother, today with a broken heart, I am in front of you.
Camera stop.
All of you knew and understand everything. We tried our best from our heart. But matter of sorrow, today Dhaka, Chittagong, Khulna, Rajshahi and Rangpur have been colored with the blood of my brothers. Today, the people of Bengal want freedom. The people of Bengal want to live. The people of Bengal want their rights. But the matter of sorrow, I have to say with the sorrow today, the painful history of 23 years, Bengal torture, and the history of bloody streets. The history of 23 years is a history of dying and crying of men and women. The history of Bengal is the history of this country sacrificing blood on the streets. In 1952, we gave blood. In 1954, though we won the election, but couldn't form the government. In 1958, Ayub Khan imposed martial law for till 10 years, made us as slaves. In 1966, for the six point movements on 7th June, they gunned down my kids on the streets. In 1969, after the fall down of Ayub Khan, where the Yahya Khan formed the government, said us he would give us constitution and will give us democracy. We all agreed his proposal. Thereafter, a lot of history went through and an election held up. All of you know, we had no fault. Today I met with President Yahya Khan, you know, made some discussions. I, not only in favor of Bengal, but the whole Pakistan, as a major party leader, requested him on the day of 15th February, you please call for a national assembly.
He refused my proposal.
But he favored Mr. Bhutto. He said it could be on first week of March. He agreed. We said, all right, we would sit for the assembly. We would discuss the matter. I said in my speech, we would discuss during assembly. Even I said to them, if someone talking about the justice, though we have the majority, even though it is a lone person, we would accept the justice. Please come and sit together. Let's prepare the constitution through discussion. He said, if the member of West Pakistan come here, then the assembly would be turned into a slaughterhouse. If someone come to the assembly, then Peshawar to Karachi, all shops would be closed by force. And even after, if someone comes again, would be homeless forever. I said, the assembly would run. And then, suddenly the assembly was closed down on the first march. What did we get? We bought weapons to protect our country from the invasion of foreign enemies. And today, those weapons are being used against my poor and unarmed general people, shooting on their chest. We are the majority people of Pakistan. We are the majority people of Pakistan. Whenever we, the Bengal people, tried to gain power, tried to be the owner of this country, they jumped onto our chest with anger. They are my brothers. I say to them, why were you shooting on your brother's chest? You were deployed to save my country from the attack of foreign enemies. Thereafter, he said, mentioning my name, that I agreed there would be a roundtable conference on the 10th of March. I want to say him clearly that I did not tell that. I talked with him over telephone. I said him, Mr. Yahya Khan, you are the president of Pakistan. Come and see. Come to Dhaka. How did they shoot down my poor people and gunfire on the chest of the Bengal people? How did they make empty the bosom of our Bengal mothers? How did they kill general people? Please you come, see and go for justice, and then you finalize that was exactly what I say. Suddenly, without discussion with me, or without discussion with us, after 5 hours secret meeting, the speech he gave and made speech during making assembly, he blamed everything on me and to the people of Bengal. I have clearly said in the meeting that the fight of this time is a fight for the liberation. The fight of this time is a fight for our independence. My dear brothers, on 25th March, they call for the assembly. Whereas the spots of blood have not been yet dried out. I said clearly on 10 March that Mujibur Rahman can join RTC after stepping over the blood of those martyrs. You call the assembly, but you must have to agree my demand first. Military rules, martial law must be withdrawn first. You must have to send back all army personnel to their barracks. The way the killings have gone, you must go for an inquiry for that. And to the people's representatives, the power has to be handed over. After that, we will consider whether we can sit in the assembly or not. Before that, to sit in the assembly, we can sit in the assembly. We can. The people have not given me that right. My dear brothers, do you have faith on me? I don't want prime ministership. We want the rights of our people. And if one shooting happen again, and if one killing happen to my people again, I have a request to you. In every home, build up the castle. Whatever you have to fight with that against the enemies. And for the sake of your life, roads and markets, whatever like that, and even if I am not able to give you further order, you will make close everything. You are my brothers. You stand back. Nobody will say anything to you. But don't try to shoot on my chest again. It will not be good. No way to dominate 7 crore peoples. No way. Whenever we have come to learn to die, then no one can dominate us. As long as my country gets freedom, all kind of taxation will remain closed. Nobody will pay tax. But I am requesting to you, you are my brothers too. Please don't destroy country like hell. We never see each other's face again in life. But if we together make it solution in a peaceful way, then there may be a way to stay together as brothers. That's why I am requesting you, don't try to run military laws in this country again. Secondly, in every village, in every locality, in every union, in every subdivision,
under the leadership of Amale, build up resistance council and stay ready, whatever you have with. Keep in mind, whenever we get blood, we will give you more, but we will liberate these people, inshallah. This time fight is a fight for our freedom. This time fight is a fight for our independence.
I believe you must trust me. In my life, I never betrayed to you even in steed of my blood. They could not pass me offering prime ministership. They could not get me even following the execution order. You people release me from the chain one day. In this escort field, I say to you, I will pay you even it is by my own blood. Remember that? I am always ready to give my blood for the country. By the way, our meeting is over now.
Bangladesh, 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 Bangladesh,